known as a targe, coming from the French word for a target. Now, it's cross-grained timber laminated together the same way as plywood is today, and it's covered in leather and heavily studded, and you'd have seen these in the cases inside. Yeah? Now in the centre there you can see this small hole, and this is where you would then place a spike, which then makes the shield into a weapon, and it's used to thrust towards people to try and stab them with the spike. So it makes the shield into a weapon as well as a form of defence. Now behind it here you can see the hand is quite free, and it's where we take on another weapon and we'll take on the dirk. And you see how this sticks at the bottom of the shield. That's then used to cut towards the legs or the arms of your opponents as you go into battle. Now in your other hand you need a sword, and this sword here was a favoured one at the time. Now this is the basket hilted broadsword, and it takes its name from the part which goes round about your hand. It will protect you in close quarter fighting. So if you can't get in to stab at someone, it's nothing personal, I understand. If you can't get to stab at someone or slash at them, when you come through, you can give them a heavy punch in the face. So it acts like a very large knuckle duster. The broad blade is a broadsword used for slashing and hacking. And down at the front down here, we've got these two small ears or lugs. Now these aren't just decorative, they also have function to trap an opponent's sword blade. If you can imagine that the dirk is someone else's sword, and you take your own and you thrust it up quickly, their sword will slide down and get caught in these ears or lugs. Give us a twist, you could break the blade and disarm the man, then putting him at a disadvantage. Now the way these weapons would be used would be in a three-way fighting motion. Now with the dirk at the back here, what you're going to do is you're going to push forward with the shield, cut down with the dirk, and then come through with the sword, and you could go through two ranks of soldiers with the technique, which was extremely effective. And that's how the Highlanders managed to punch their way through the line of the barrels and the Munros. Now put these just here for a sec.
A nice photo, but not with the coach there. Maybe we'll do that
in a minute.
Yeah.
Right, now this here is the Highland garb. What I'm wearing just now is probably some would say a Victorian adaptation of it, but what we've got here is the old style, which is called the Fillamore. And the Fillamore means the great kilt or the big kilt. Can you hold that corner for me? Take a wee walk back. Keep going.
Wow, that's
there we go.
Huge.
And that is it. Yeah. So this is the Fillamore, the big kilt or the great kilt. Okay. Yep. Yeah. Let it go. Drop it.
I bet it's heavy when it's wet.
Yeah.
Now with this, taking this like this, what we do, we're going to arrange it in such a way that it's going to make it easy to put it on and take off. Okay. So put it on the ground like so. Now what I need to do is to reduce the length of this, and I do that by folding it. So pick up the fabric, pull it towards me, and it creates the first of the pleats, you see? Then I'm going to carry on with this process until all of the fabric has been pleated. Now there's no set length or width to the pleats, it just depends upon the person who's making the garment up and how much fabric they actually have available to them. Now taking this like so, we just keep on doing this until all of the fabric has been pleated. Now with this particular thing you can see that the pleats are going side by side. They're not one directly on top of another. Now the idea will be that the pleats will then be stretching right around your back, which will give you some comfort and protection. The protection is from the cold ground when you sit down, and with all that fabric giving you that padding, saves you from getting piles or hemorrhoids. Right, now to hold it together, you use a belt. If you've got a leather belt, you can use that. But I've got this here, which will do absolutely fine. Putting this here, put this underneath, and we're going to slide this up to roughly where the waist is going to go. You then open that up, like so, and that's it then ready to go on. You want to give it a go? Come on.
Come on. Never worn a skirt before.
Give her your camera.
Yeah, good. Well, I'll send you later.
Yeah, my battery's
gone. Oh, is it gone?
It's gone.
Okay, so you're going to sit down on the pleats there, so turn around.
Down.
Sit down. That's it, sit down there, yep. Okay. Now I need you to kind of put your hands down, pick your bottom up, slide back just a little touch. Oh, not too much, that's too much. That way again. That's fine, lie down. Okay, put your hands behind your head and relax. Highlanders can get dressed by themselves, just so you all know. Okay. So I'm going to take this. And we're going to take this and put this across the front like so. And we bring this part across here. And what we've done now is we've created the aprons to a kilt. Taking the belt, I'll get your waist there.
Yeah.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Take the belt, tie the belt, nice and tight. You still breathing there?
Just about to meet it.
Okay, so get that through there. Okay, that did the job. Okay, tighten them up. There we go. Okay. So just let that hang down like so. Give us a twirl, turn around for me. Okay. Now, as you see, it does look a little bit long on him. If he goes charging into the battle with this on, he's going to trip up and fall flat in his face. So what we need to do is we need to tie it up. So, turn around, this way. Hold that corner there for me. Mm-hmm. I take this corner here, and I tuck this into the belt. Now, this part here, I take that, measure down a couple of arm lengths of the fabric, and then take this here up onto the shoulder like so, bring this part across the front, and this side on here will do the same job as a plaid brooch would do. Okay, I've got that there, coming onto this side here. Now personally speaking, when I'm wearing something like this, I don't like this part hanging down. So what I'll do is I'll take this and I'll tuck this into the belt as well. Okay, now put your hand inside here for me, and then put your hand just inside here. Hold your hands out a little bit, turn around facing one. And you see now what we've got on either side here are these very large pockets, which are very handy for your duty free when you go on your holiday. Yeah, okay. Give us a twirl. And there you go. Excellent.
Wow. Excellent. Well done.
With this particular garment, if he's out, get cold, wet, doesn't matter. What you do is pull that out from the belt there, drop this down off of the shoulder, pull this here then up onto the head here, and that will then keep you nice and cosy warm as you're walking around. It won't keep you dry, but it does keep you nice and warm. I'm just going to turn you around so everyone can see your good side. There it is there. Okay, right, wiggle your ass for me then. There we go, he's going to swing the kilt. Now if I take a needle and thread and stitch along just where the belt is, that will keep the pleats in, and you can cut the top part away, and what you're then left with is a small kilt. Okay. And this is where it originated from. Right, okay. Put your arm back through there. Okay, put this into here. We'll just dress you properly.
Yeah. Oh my god. Wow.
Yeah, then get your arm through there.
Then you
get that there. And then you can put that through there. Hold on to that. And now you can get a fine photograph. Now make sure you get a good one, because it'll probably be the last time you see him dressed like a real man.